Aha! This is exactly the tool you're gonna need if you're gonna solve a case in MicroMacro Crime City. This is a game for 1 to 4 players, plays in under an hour. My name is Etorakos, this is another Peaky Boardgamer's episode, and I should start explaining the rules right now. Before your first game, you're gonna have to do a little bit of sorting. The game includes many cards, most of them are black, but there are also some white cards. You're gonna need the side of the card that depicts this symbol, and you're gonna use this symbol in order to separate the cards to 16 different card sets. Try not to look at the other side of these cards, or at least avoid paying attention to them, because they contain case solutions and other hints. Then you need to sort the cards of each set, so that the first card is on top, and the last card is in the bottom. You will always have the white card in the top of the stack, which displays the name of the case, as well as some star symbols indicating the difficulty of the specific case. As I said, you will end up with 16 different cases for you to solve. Complete this one-time preparation by placing each one of these sets to these envelopes that are included in the box. In each game, you're trying to solve one of the cases, so at the start, you need to select one of those either at random, or you may select the one you want according to the preferred difficulty. However, if you are new players, the game suggests that you start with these 5 cases, played in the order I show you in the graphics. Place the big city map in the middle of the table. The game comes with a magnifying glass that you may use in order to find the little details on the map. Place it next to the map. You could also find handy to use markers of any sort in order to indicate locations that are important to your case. However, you should note that these markers are not included in the box. Place the selected case next to the board as well, and now it's time to select one of the players who will take the role of the lead investigator. The game is now ready to start. Of course, I don't want to spoil you anything from the cases included in the box, so I will only spoil you what is already spoiled in the rulebook of the game from the Top Hat introductory case. The lead investigator flips the white start card and starts to read aloud all the information on the card to the other players. The card says, Fernando Branca was on the way to his local pub. Upon arrival, he noticed that his top hat has disappeared. The pub is located in the east of the city, between Neptune Park and the hardware store. Now the first task of the players is to find the pub. Players now freely move around the table, searching for the location required by the specific task, using the hints given from the previous cards. When the team believes that they have found the solution of the task, in this case the pub, the lead investigator secretly checks the other side of the task card to see if the team is right. The card depicts a picture of the solution as well as the coordinates of the location on the map. If the team was right, then the lead investigator proceeds and reads all the text in the right side of the card, and then the team continues with the next task. Otherwise, the lead investigator informs the team that they're wrong and that they must continue the search. As you can realize, after the lead investigator knows the solution of the specific task, he may not actively contribute in the search. He leaves the rest of the team find the solution by themselves. However, he may offer hints if he believes that the rest of the team is completely misled. When the team successfully finds the solution of the last task, the game is over and the case is solved. Last but not least, if you want an even bigger challenge, do the following. After you read all the information in the start card, try to find all the solutions of the tasks without checking the other side of these cards. When the team believes they have all the questions answered, they start to flip all the cards one at a time to see if they were correct. This will be much more difficult since you gain no hints from solving one task at a time. So that was the video for MicroMacro Crime City, a very entertaining and different game that anyone can play. If you like this video and want to see more videos like that, please subscribe to my channel, and until next time, have fun and play more board games.